Yes, Shahid.
Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh.
Shahidullah.
Sheikh, I've got a question.
Yes.
Sir, Allah says in Quran, don't come to Salah in the state of intoxication because you don't understand what the Imam is saying.
Okay.
In this context, I'm a non-Arab. I don't understand Arabic. Where does my Salah stand in the sight of Allah?
Okay. Any more questions?
In the same context, during Asr and Zuhr, sir, the Imam doesn't recites slowly. We don't understand. We don't hear the recitation. So, what do you have to say for this?
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
I will answer, inshallah. About a verse in the Quran where Allah Azza wa Jal says, يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تقربوا الصلاة وأنتم سكارى حتى تعلموا ما تقولون. O you who believe, do not approach prayer while in the state of intoxication until you know, until you understand what you're saying. So it doesn't have anything to do with the Imam reciting. Even if the Imam was reciting Arabic and you're an Arab, but you're in the state of intoxication, you should not pray. And why is that? Because the Prophet والسلام, even told us that if one of you is praying night prayer and he is a bit drowsy, feeling sleepy, he should retire and sleep. Because in this situation, you may ask Allah for forgiveness, and instead of saying, Oh Allah, forgive me, you say, Oh Allah, curse me. Because you're not focusing. So the Prophet tells you, no, you have to stop, you have to go and retire and sleep. Likewise, if a person is praying while in the state of intoxication, he's drunk. Instead of asking for forgiveness, he may curse himself. And one of the people who used to drink, he quit drinking after once being wasted, then urinating in a bowl, and then performing wudu, washing his face with his urine, and saying, Oh Allah, make me among those who purify themselves, and make me among those who repent. Allahumma ij'alni min tawwabin wa ij'alni min mutatahhirin. This is what you say after making wudu. And afterwards, when he was sobered and saw what he had done to himself, he took a vow not to drink again. You don't have to reach that level. You just simply have to submit your will and know that it is haram for you to drink or to be even close to drinking. This verse deals with you not knowing what you're saying. Not because you don't understand the language, rather because you are not in a state of mental health or mental case. So that allows you to do something that is permissible. Rather, you are in a state of temporary insanity. When you're intoxicated, you do things and then you regret it. You do things and you don't remember it. You do things that you would never have thought of even doing when you were not drunk. So this is what the ayah is referring to. As for Asr and Dhuhr, it's the same thing. It is no, there is no relation, none whatsoever, to what the Imam is reciting, because you are reciting the Fatiha on your own, reciting the Surah on your own, and making dua on your own, and Allah Azza wa Jal knows best.